The decision by the Jubilee headquarters to expel 9 MCAs from Bomet on grounds that they have rebelled against the party continues to rock the deputy president's party, with Governor Isaac Ruto now promising a bruising battle. Governor Ruto says the party at the national level has no leadership structure and therefore has no capacity to expel anyone.
Who is the national chair?
He wondered why the party would fault the MCAs for not representing the party's interests, yet their roles in the assembly target special groups. He also dared the party to sack him.
As they are not representing the party. If you are a disabled, you represent the disabled. One each time and a disabled.
If you are an elected, you serve the people who elected you. But when you are nominated, it is common sense that you have to serve the party. Those MCAs who are not representing the wishes of the party should cease enjoying the privilege of that party.
Meanwhile, in what is likely to escalate the political storm in Rift Valley region over the move to abandon URP and join the Jubilee Alliance Party, Deputy President William Ruto told Rift Valley legislators he met at the Western Hotel in Nairobi last night that the new outfit was the political vehicle to ride on in 2017. The deputy president challenged the more than 100 MPs to use the National Assembly recess to intensify the sensitization of supporters on the planned exodus to the new party. The move is likely to widen the rift in the Rift Valley region, pitting the DP against Bomet Governor Isaac Ruto, who appears to have fallen out with his party leader over the Rift Valley leadership mantle and political direction. If they indeed march into JAP in the expected numbers, the legislators will have further complicated the Rift Valley political power games, which have seen Baringo Senator Gideon Moi and the chair of the Council of Governors Isaac Ruto strongly differ with Deputy President William Ruto. Kenda Gor, Obadiah Citizen, Weekend.